हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम रेखा मोरे, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम आर्ट साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज सेखेड़ा। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टू डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ ट्रांसफरेंस एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर। सो फ्रेंड्स, ट्रांसफरेंस एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर वी हैड डिस्कस इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो। ट्रांसफरेंस नंबर और ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर इज डिनोटेड बाय टी प्लस और टी माइनस, एंड हाउ टू डिटरमाइन दिस थ्योरेटिकल पार्ट वी हैज ऑलरेडी डिस्कस, बट एक्सपेरिमेंटली हाउ वी विल बी डिटरमाइन दिस। देयरफॉर द एक्सपेरिमेंटली डिटरमाइन ट्रांसफरेंस नंबर बाय थ्री मेथड्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज द हिटॉक्स मेथड, द सेकेंड इज द मूविंग बाउंड्री मेथड, एंड थर्ड वन इज इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स मेजरमेंट। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फर्स्ट मेथड, दैट इज द हिटॉक्स मेथड। सो फ्रेंड्स, लुक टुवर्ड दिस डायग्राम। इन दिस डायग्राम देयर वेयर द टू कंपार्टमेंट। फर्स्ट कंपार्टमेंट इज कैथोड कंपार्टमेंट, देन दिस वन साइड कंपार्टमेंट इज एनोड कंपार्टमेंट, then the center portion is like a U shape and this known as the center compartment. Whatever we had studied in Hitoff's rule, that compartment is given in this method in the form of apparatus. Okay, in that Hitoff's rule we had studied the three compartment in the same container, and in that case we had just studied how the ions is moved from one place to the another place, or from one place to the oppositely charged electrode. But in this case we use the apparatus. Look toward the apparatus. Each and every apparatus having a loop at the end, and both the compartment is filled up with the solution at the same level. Then the cathode compartment means cathode electrode is joined to millimeter. Then anode compartment is joined to coulometer, and coulometer is adjustable with the resistance, and both anode and cathode is joined toward the battery. The battery is denoted by B, and behind that battery there is the switch. Okay, now look toward that, the coulometer is denoted by C, anode compartment here one, then center part is denoted by A, cathode compartment is this one, and this complete circuit diagram is known as the Hitoff's apparatus. So friend, let's start the discussion regarding to this. What will be happen? The apparatus consists of transport cell A is connected in series with silver coulometer. Transport cell A silver coulometer is connected to a battery B through the variable resistance R. The millimeter M in the circuit permit adjust to any desired value, and it is possible to rough estimate the quantity of electricity passed through it. Then current is stopped and solution are drained from the both the compartment. They are weighed and analyzed. How the solution are weighed and how they are analyzed, we will be discussing in case first and case second. A coulometer is used to determine the quantity of electricity passed through the solution. Okay, and how much changes are take place in the solution when electricity is passed. And suppose there is a silver, the silver is deposited in the coulometer, and that how much amount of the silver is deposited in the coulometer is weighed, and after weighing we are determined the how much amount of the silver is displaced from the solution. So friend, this is the Hitoff's apparatus, and the same assignment I have uploaded on the Google Classroom. Draw neat and label diagram of Hitoff's experimental apparatus. So friends, you should be careful to drawing the Hitoff's apparatus, because number of time the same question has been asked. Okay, now when we proceed toward that, before proceed we should be understand the silver coulometer is used for precise work. It consists of platinum disc. Okay, in this coulometer the silver platinum plate is used, and that vessel is filled with purified aqueous solution of silver nitrate and act as a cathode. means what? Silver nitrate is act as a cathode. Pure silver rod is deep into the aqueous solution of silver nitrate, act as a anode. Means what? The silver nitrate solution is act as a cathode and pure silver rod is act as a anode. Okay friends, the increase in weight of platinum dish due to the deposition of the silver is determined usual procedure and quantity of electricity passed through the solution and through the coulometer is determined and it is equal to quantity of the electricity passed through the cell. This experiment is can be performed using attackable electrodes. Say attackable electrode means what? Suppose if you have to consider silver, silver nitrate, copper, copper sulfate, means what? In this case the copper is deposited or silver is deposited, and non-attackable electrode also we have to use, like platinum and inert electrode, platinum lead, etc. So friend, no, lead we cannot be use here, platinum, gold, etc. So friends, this is the discussion regarding to Hittorf's apparatus. Now, this apparatus is useful to determine the transference or transport number. And how it can be determined? As we know that how much number of ions is moved from one place to the another place. If the velocity of the ions are same, that is a V plus by V minus is equal to T plus by T minus. But friends, there is also one of the second case. Not each and every ions not in equal velocity. Sometimes anions are run faster than the cations, and therefore the velocity ratio will be changed regarding to the rate of the movement of the ions. Now in the Hittorf's method we go toward the calculations. This calculation we will be done after passing the electric current and before passing the electric current. So friend, look toward this. After passing the electric current, the weight of anodic solution taken out means what? In first and second compartment, means anode and cathode compartment, we are filling the silver nitrate solution with a proper concentration, and after passing electricity we just take out the solution from the anodic compartment. And that solution we measure in the gram. The weight of electrolyte taken, that is also in gram. Weight of water, how to determine weight of water? X minus Y is equal to weight of water, of course, which is also in the gram. The weight of silver deposited in silver coulometer, that is denoted by W, and it is in the gram. Number 5, equivalent of silver, D, is equal to, how to determine? 108 is the equivalent weight of the silver, and therefore the weight of the silver deposited in the coulometer by 108 is equal to equivalence. So friends, this is the readings regarding to the after passing the electric current. But before passing the electric current, one thing is very important, that is the weight of electrolyte associated with X minus gram of the water. Means what? How much gram of the electrolyte are present before passing the electricity, and that is denoted by Z. Now there is the two case. In case one, when electrode attackable, such as silver, silver nitrate, copper, copper sulfate, lead, lead sulfate, etc., the anions migrate toward anode and attack anode, forming the electrolyte. And the concentration of the electrolyte increases in the anode compartment. So friends, what happened here? One of the anions is migrate toward the anode. Anode containing a positive charge, anions is a negative charge, and negative charge particle is moved toward the anode and attack, and therefore the electrolyte concentration have been increases in the compartment of anode. Then number 2, increase in concentration of anode compartment is determined by Y minus Z is equal to G. Then in previous case, Y is what? The weight of electrolyte taken, and Z is what? Z is nothing but the weight of electrolyte associated with the water. Okay, and when we find out increase in concentration, that is a Y minus Z, you will be get G. Increase in concentration in anode compartment is denoted by E, means whatever the reading you will be getting first, y minus z equation, you have to put here, and that is nothing but the equivalent of cation. This can be determined by using the molecular weight of electrolyte and equivalent weight of corresponding metal. If no cations had migrated from anode, the increase in concentration is equal to D. Fall in concentration due to migration of cation, that is D minus E. Hence, transport number of cation T plus is denoted by D minus E by D. The transport number of anions, of course, T plus plus T minus is equal to 1. So friend, if you remember the value of T plus, that is a D minus E by D, you are also able to find out value of anion, that is a 1 minus T plus. You just substitute the value of T plus, 1 minus D minus E by D, you will be get the value of anion, that is a E by D. When you solve it, you will be get the answer E by D. In case second, when electrodes are non-attackable, means inert platinum electrode or gold electrode, such electrodes are inert and they are non-attackable in nature. Therefore, fall in concentration of anode compartment due to migration of cations. Okay, in that case what happened? Increase in concentration in anodic compartment. In this case what happened? Fall in concentration of anode compartment, means completely opposite process have been take place in case of attackable and non-attackable electrode. So friend, when such a decrease in concentration we want to find out, having a formula x minus y, as we know what is the x and what is the y, and equivalent cations is equal to E, and whatever the value you will be get, that is a gram equivalence. Therefore, transport number of cation is E by D, and transport number of anion is 1 minus E by D. So friend, this is the case of electrode non-attackable. And in this way, we have to finish the Hittorf's method to determine the transport number. So friend, when we go through this method, suppose the question is come, write and explain the Hittorf's method to determine the transference or transport number. Suppose such a type of the question is come, how to write down the answer of this question? Suppose the question carry 4 marks or 6 marks, that time you should be do that. First of all, you have to write down what is the transport number. Transport number is denoted by T plus, and which having a capacity to carry the current. Okay, how much amount of the current is carried by the ions, that quantity is determined by the transport number. Okay, so friend, this is the introductory part, and then you will be write down that how to determine the transference number. The transference number we have to determine by using the 3 methods: the Hittorf's method, moving boundary method, and electromotive force method. And after getting this one, then you label the Hittorf's method as a title and write down the explanation regarding to the diagram. And at the same time, you have to draw neat and clean diagram with a label, and then proceed to the calculations. Calculation is so easy. First, you have to write down the weight of solution before and after passing the electricity, and then use the 2 cases. First case for the attackable electrode, second case for the non-attackable electrode. As my opinion, this much information is sufficient for the answer. Okay, thank you very much. In our next video, we will be discuss about the moving boundary method.